Hey guys, what's up? Eric Merced here, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can use Comic Draw app and Procreate together to create comics. So a lot of people love to color, sketch, or ink inside of Procreate. I am one of them, and we basically love to do as much as we can inside the app, but as you know, Procreate can't handle a lot of things as of the latest version. For example, it's a little difficult to create panel borders when you're doing comics, and it's pretty difficult to create lettering. So the technique that I'm going to show you today is basically how to use Comic Draw to fill in the gaps in Procreate, allowing you to finish most of your work inside of Procreate. So let's go ahead and switch over to Comic Draw app so you guys can see what I'm talking about. So I have this comic here called Planet Crusher, which I'm currently working on. And I started working on this comic inside of Comic Draw app. I started sketching it out. I went ahead and did the letters, I did the panels, I did everything that I could until I finally realized, you know what, I love Comic Draw app, but I really want to do this comic inside of Procreate. So it dawned on me that that's possible. So what I did was I finished my borders and I finished all my type, and it's really easy to get this file over to Procreate. And the way we do that is by hitting the tools icon symbolized by a wrench and choosing share current page. Now we can do this in one of two ways. We can either send a copy or open in another app. So we're just going to go ahead and choose open in another app. And that's going to give us a format to choose from, about six formats to choose from. There's the Comic Draw, PDF, and EPUB formats, which we're going to export to Procreate. Neither of these formats are going to work. Then there's the JPEG, Photoshop, and PNG format. The JPEG and PNG formats are going to produce flattened files. In other words, no layer information is going to be retained in the exported file. So our target is Photoshop or PSD. That's the format we want to export because that is compatible with Procreate. So let's go ahead and hit PSD. Comic Draw is going to go ahead and generate a file for us to export. We're going to go ahead and choose how to send, and we're going to get the iOS 11's share sheet that's going to come up. Now, I have Add to Procreate as my first choice, but if you don't see Add to Procreate here, just swipe to the right and see if you find it. If you can't find it, go ahead and hit the More tab and scroll down until you see Add to Procreate, and you can toggle it on and off, and you can also move it to the location that you want within the share sheet. So once that's done, we can go ahead and hit Add to Procreate. Comic Draw is going to send it to Procreate. And we're going to go ahead and switch over to Procreate to finish the export. This is really important. So once we switch over, Procreate is going to start the importing process. If we wait a little too long, this is going to not happen. So we want to do it right after we tap on the send button or the export button. So as you can see, the first page that I exported is right there. We're going to tap on it. And there you go. The same exact page that we created inside of Comic Draw is exported and imported into Procreate. So the cool thing about it is if we go and check out the canvas information, the dimensions and the DPI remain the same. Dimensions are 7 inches by 10.5 inches. And the DPI is 300. So we don't lose any quality in the file. And the really cool thing about it is that we retain all of our layers. So we have our sketch layer. We have our panel layers, which are called drawing. And then we have our lettering layer. And the cool thing about this is you can, if you want to edit something, for example, if you want to change the position of this over to here, you can do it. You don't lose any ability to edit your files. So now let's say we create, let me go ahead and delete this. Let's say we create a panel entirely in Comic Draw. Let me give you an example. So here's a comic I created entirely in comic draw. It's called Trolls. And just to show you, I did the sketching and the penciling inside of comic draw. I did the inks inside of comic draw. And of course, I did all of the lettering and panel borders inside of comic draw. So this comic from start to finish was created inside of comic draw. It's about 3 pages long. But let's say I've done all this work and I want to color my comic and I don't want to color it necessarily in comic draw. Well, we're going to do the same exact thing. We're going to go ahead and hit the tools icon. We're going to share the current page, or we can share the entire comic, but let's just stick to sharing the current page. And we're going to send open in another app. Again, choose PSD because we want to keep all those layers intact. You can choose PNG just to have a flattened file. But if you have the ability, why not just go ahead and send the whole entire editable file over to Procreate? So let's go ahead and hit PSD. Comic Draw is going to go ahead and generate a version of the file in Photoshop format. We'll choose how to send it, and again, we'll choose Add to Procreate, and Comic Draw will go ahead and send that file over to Procreate. So again, we'll switch over to Procreate quickly, and Procreate will go ahead and import the file. Once the file is imported, we can go ahead and open it, and we will see that, again, just to show you, nothing has changed. 7 by 10.5 inches, 300 DPIs, color space is the same, everything's the same. And again, the cool thing about it is if we open our layers palette, we have our sketching group where all our sketches or our pencils are. We have the line art. Now we have a panels group, and then we have a lettering. So if we go ahead and turn all of this off and turn on the sketching group, you can see my original pencils are there. Turn on the line art, panels group, and the lettering group. And I can easily color this file and retain all of my layers intact if I ever want to make any changes in the future. Guys, I hope this has been a helpful video for you guys. I hope you've learned something. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video. God bless and have a good one. Bye.